I'm a bit sceptical of that draw, to be honest. I get it, you're in the Champions League and you're going to get hit with big teams, but my concern is away to Dortmund and away to Villa. I think they two are hard, and Atalanta as well. So I'm a bit sceptical with that draw, to be honest. I'm a bit worried.
So you think this is a harder draw than Celtic could have got?
Not a harder draw, but I just think that I was like Mark. I was looking forward to this new format to see how it's going to pan out, and I just think when you look at some of the away ties we've got, Celtic in Europe are the better teams, and I just think over the years in Europe we've suffered some hefty defeats, and I just think when you look at the teams that we've got and the amount of money these teams spend. Now Celtic have only brought in two new players this transfer window. We brought in Bernardo, he was there last year, and Ida was there last year, so we've only actually replaced two players. And for me, I don't think we've got the squad depth to do the Champions League this year. I don't.
And that's the thing, Mark. It's like, that is understandable. These are good teams, but I think your alternate, you can't, in this format of the Champions League, you're going to play eight teams. You can't play teams that don't have money. Like, do you know what I mean? So it's sort of... You're looking at what's the best of a bad bunch, yeah, or whatever the phrase would be. So in isolation, obviously Ross is right, like Dortmund's tough, Atlanta, these teams have more money than Celtic, but like pretty much everyone in the competition,
you're in the elite competition, European competition. If you wanted to come up against equals to you, then you're talking Conference League, and even in that league some people have got more money. So the Champions League, you're always going to be dwarfed by budget because of our surroundings in the league we're in. That's just the position we're in this country. But there is still teams. You have to look at the way as well Celtic are playing at the minute and think they're in a good place. And then I'm sure over the days and weeks, people will start doing their analysis on that opposition. I was just quickly looking at Young Boys there, who don't look like they've started their league particularly good. I know they won it last year, but they're sitting bottom just now after five games, not won a game. And you're thinking, well, you know, how does, you know, you have to take into consideration who you're up against. So Celtic will fancy themselves against some, but they'll obviously know there's big tests there.